BTS ate you up on your own song. So embarrassing. You tagged every single one of them, and you can't tag BTS who got you to this point. You can't even tag one BTS underscore official underscore big hit. You can't do that.
We have the women of BTS, but they've got the same haircut. They've got the same weird contacts. This outfit just doesn't make any sense at all. I don't even know what to call them, boys or girls, because I don't know what they are. Old Pinky Lee. How do you guys tell these people apart?
I hate K-pop. I don't get BTS. How did this become a thing in Western culture where grown men and little girls are jerking off to little K-pop boys? It's a little fetish. It's like a little twink gay fetish about these K-pop boys.
I think it's basic for everyone that since the entertainment world is super big as well as low-key competitive, being liked by everyone is impossible. I mean, it will never happen. Even BTS experienced a lot of nasty things, especially from American personalities, since we all know that there are still a lot of people who couldn't accept the fact that the boys made it big in the US. And I mean mega hit kind of big, which surprisingly offended their egos. However, this didn't stop people from attacking them, especially targeting the boys with racist remarks. Some hitting on them secretly while the others aren't very discreet about it at all, which made fans think that they actually hate the boys with passion. Well, in case you want to hear about these rude celebrities, then make sure to keep watching. Okay, let's start with Ethan Klein. I think most of you don't know him, but he's actually pretty famous. He and his wife do a podcast called the H3 Podcast, where they talk about literally anything. So, recently he started this podcast series, Frenemies, with Trisha Paytas, who we all know because of her famous memes that went viral some years back. In this specific podcast, Ethan made very racist and homophobic remarks about BTS. And when I say what he said about the boys is straight up rude and nasty, I mean it. Like, he literally declared that he doesn't like K-pop, and that he hates K-pop, which is the reason why he doesn't get the hype over BTS. He even commented about their looks and said that the whole K-pop fan culture is like a creepy fetish of fangirls going crazy over, quote, twink gay grown-up men. Ethan didn't stop there and continued belittling armies and fans in general. He even made fun of how fangirls would spaz over their idols on Twitter as if there was something wrong about doing so, which we all know that there isn't. Come on, we can support our idols the way we want to, right? Ugh, he just gets on my nerves. But since they are BTS, the amount of hate they receive can be massive as well. But for this instance, it's because of ridiculous reasons fans will never understand. Moving on, we have BeFree. Okay, I bet most armies are over this guy, but I think he needs to be included in the list since what he did to BTS is still unforgivable. The incident happened way back in 2013 when the boys were just starting in the music industry. We all know that RM and Suga were originally underground rappers before they ultimately debuted as idols. Anyway, the two were invited to a show which aimed to somehow connect underground rappers with idol rappers, and RM and Suga gladly participated since it's not every day you get a chance to end ongoing discrimination against artists. However, BeFree didn't like the fact that the two chose to debut as idols. He started insulting them and their music and even went ahead and commented on their looks, saying that they look like girls wearing makeup and fancy clothes whenever they perform on stage. Armies were furious after hearing his comments. I know this happened in 2013, but it doesn't change the fact that wearing makeup doesn't make a man less manly. Just like how not wearing makeup will make you manlier than others, his parade of hateful comments didn't stop there, since he proudly shared that he doesn't listen to BTS albums or music, since he doesn't like it. Of course, fans were quick to call him out, to which he replied saying, "If you're thinking about what I said today for over 20 minutes, I sincerely recommend finding a boyfriend." Rude. This guy is really something. However, his nasty comments ended up backfiring at him 6 years after when BTS became certified global superstars. He finally posted an apology, which fans thought was way too late now. See, that's what happens when you judge a book by its cover. And the moral of the story? Well, hating on BTS will never bring you good things. Next up, Jason Derulo. ARMYs know that BTS is very humble. This is the reason why many people are still in awe at how nice the boys are, despite the massive success they've achieved. Remember when they first placed number one at the Billboard Top 100? BTS was ecstatic and immediately called Bang PD to share the good news, and of course to express their gratitude. This is exactly what they did when their collab with Jason Derulo for Savage Love topped the same prestigious chart. However, Jason Derulo is the complete opposite since he basically omitted BTS from his success when it happened. I mean, he acted as if he is the sole reason why the song achieved so much, even though it's clear that broad daylight that he would never come close to topping Billboard without the help of BTS. In a video he uploaded on his TikTok, the singer was seen celebrating number one. He even shouted, "I got number one," without taking the time to thank BTS or even just mention them. I mean, that's the least he can do, right? To make things worse, he never tagged BTS on his social media post when he announced the milestone the song achieved. If he doesn't hate BTS, then I don't see any other reason why he would literally forget them. It's called collaboration for a reason. Of course, the fans were livid, stating the glaring fact that he would never top the chart without the help of BTS. His statement during his interview with the Ellen DeGeneres show left ARMYs speechless. When asked how the collaboration came about, he answered saying, quote, "I met them a few years ago. The members came up to me, but I didn't know who they were." Wow, the audacity. He continued by saying, "An American singer, a New Zealand composer, and a massive K-pop group ended up working together." Continuing his no mentioning BTS agenda. Because of this, fans started boycotting the song to the point media outlets reported the sudden decline Savage Love experienced after what happened. Billboard even released a report that the purchased ARMYs made was the reason why the song became on the top spot. I hope he gets a reality check that he needs, because being ignorant and rude will definitely bring him to his demise, especially if the person he is hating is BTS. Coming up, we have Howard Stern. I think a lot of you will recognize Howard Stern from the popular show America's Got Talent. Also, I'm sure you are aware that he's kind of known to be a germaphobe of some sort. Recently, he hosted a radio show with SiriusXM, which is his main gig at the moment, and this is where he said the nastiest things about the boys. I mean, really rude things against BTS. This happened when BTS was in the same building where he was also doing his radio show. The boys were there to promote A Map of the Soul 7. During Howard's radio broadcast, he started talking about COVID. And without any valid reason, a staff member mentioned that BTS is in the same building and that they might be infected with COVID. He said, "There's no way those guys don't have the coronavirus." This was not the last time he said racist remarks on the show, since there was another instance where he mocked the Korean language. Like, really? If you can't watch a Korean movie without subtitles, then there's definitely something wrong with you. Last on the list is Shallon Lester. The actress found herself on the hot seat when she made a statement about being confused about the boys of BTS. Well, in case you thought that what she meant by confusion is not being able to differentiate their faces from each other, since most people who are new to K-pop find it troublesome to do so, even though most K-pop groups don't look alike. Anyway, Shallon explained that what she is confused about is how she should call BTS, since she's not very sure whether they are boys or girls. Seriously, even a 5-year-old knows how to identify, which is why fans were furious when they heard her comment. It didn't take long before ARMYs were voicing out their disappointment regarding her obvious racist and discriminatory comments. It's 2021, and yet there are still closed-minded people who don't know how to treat people with respect. I hope you guys didn't get stressed out because of these rude celebs. If it did, let us know in the comments down below, and make sure to give this video a like and stay tuned for more. See you next time!